I mean, I'm a national statistician, and I'm also head of the Government Statistical Service and head of the Government Analysis Function. Say a few words about being head of the Government Analysis Function. Through that, I work collaboratively with the heads of profession right across government in order to aim to get analysis embedded at the heart of all decision making and working and co-creating policy, for example, with our colleagues in the policy profession. To do this, I chair the Analysis Function Board, which brings together the heads of profession from across government, from all the professions that constitute the Analysis Function, the Government Actuaries Department, the geographers, the Government Social Research, Government Operational Research, Government Economic Service, as well as the Government Statistical Service. And that gives us an opportunity to work together to make sure that we are making the whole bigger than the sum of the parts, and we are truly working to embed analysis at the heart of government decision making. And finally, I'm also privileged to attend the Heads of Function Steering Group. And that's really important because I am passionate in support of the government's agenda to have, if you like, horizontal functions right across government accompanying the vertical substantive areas, which basically are departments. And being able to work with the other heads of function to make sure that the intersections are being properly addressed is, I think, an important agenda, that one that I value very much. Yeah, I think analysts right across government are civil servants who work in the collection, in the production, and in the communication of official statistics. And I think it's incredibly important to say that while we produce a number of official statistics, much of what we do is done in partnership with colleagues elsewhere in government, for example, with the policy community, in order to provide evidence for analysis. So we produce around 2,000 sets of statistics each year. They're absolutely critical for government decisions. We provide professional advice to people, and we work with other civil servants to co-create analysis, which are the basis of the evidence that government uses for many, many policy decisions. Well, one of the great things about this role is that no 2 days are the same. But if I were to summarize, I would say I spend some of the time having bilaterals with senior colleagues to make sure that we are getting our policies all aligned and really moving forward with the right analytic agendas. I spend some of my time in government-wide meetings. Over the last year of the pandemic, attending SAGE has been an important one. And I spend some of my time in external meetings as an ambassador representing the Office of National Statistics, either with other parts of government or with external players such as the national academies, or indeed internationally with organisations such as the UN Statistical Division or the OECD. So no 2 days are the same, but often addressing many of the same kinds of agenda. And quite often I have the opportunity also to do some really good conversations which involve some hard statistics. Okay, well, I did a degree and then a master's in statistics. During my master's in statistics at the London School of Economics, I read an unbelievably impressive academic paper by a man called Richard Cormack, and serendipitously, he had a PhD grant. I applied for it brilliantly. He gave it to me, and so I did a PhD with him in Scotland, and that was a wonderful experience. And after that, which gave me a real feel for applied statistics and the real opportunities for applied statistics to impact on policy. I worked on Scottish education with Richard. And then I was privileged to get an academic job as a lecturer at the university, first of Heriot Watt, and then very quickly afterwards at Southampton. And the group at Southampton was a small group, but a group that were passionate, every one, about good, hard, rigorous statistics, but using data and in the service of society. And I spent a long time there, going from a lecturer to being a professor and working on the analysis of large data sets, often with respect to demographic issues in the UK and indeed in many low-income countries, and increasingly moved towards some interests in census, and had the privilege to work in partnership with ONS around the 2001 census. Subsequently to that, I applied for and was invited to lead the Economic and Social Research Council, and then I led a university, and then I had the opportunity to come and take this job, which has been a total thrill. They've changed in many, many ways. I mean, the first is a purely, if you like, domestic issue. We have, as a community, worked from home, as has the civil service, and that has meant an enormous change in ways of working. I've been incredibly impressed that our colleagues in IT have enabled that to happen, but we have really needed to elide into a new way of working. And the success of that, I think, is clear from the quality of the work that has happened. Secondly, the pandemic has been an opportunity for us to speed up many of the things that we wanted to do, to become ever more agile, to become ever more adaptable and flexible, and to meet the growing demand for trusted data and analysis. And I was absolutely privileged to be part of the first Analysis in Government Awards held in December, which demonstrated the real wealth of exceptional work undertaken by the government analysis function. And I just wanted to make it very, very clear that the celebration there was across both COVID and non-COVID related projects. And I think one of the most incredibly impressive things of the last year is the way in which business as usual has been continued, while at the same time bringing innovative and radical new ways of collecting data, which have made decision-making at the heart of government ever more evidence-based. Well, I think there's lots and lots of opportunities. You know, analysts come in many shape or forms, and statisticians come in many shapes and forms. Increasingly, people are coming into the profession through apprenticeships, and there are apprenticeship opportunities, data analyst level 4 and level 6 apprenticeships. And I really encourage anyone considering that to really take them seriously, because it's a great way to really be understanding the excitement of the role while at the same time learning. We also, at a different level, have the government fast streams. And there are fast streams in statistics, in economics, in operational research, and in social research. And often some of our fast streamers have previously had student placement opportunities, and a number of those exists. One of the things I'm really clear in my mind about is that each of the professions within the analysis function has a structured career, so that you know what it is you have to do over time in order to move forward. So, for example, in the statistics profession, we've just launched an online skills tool to help people plan their career and the development they need at different times in order to support their growing skills and knowledge. The Operational Research Service and some members of the geography profession have also been onboarded to the tool, and we hope to expand this across the wider analysis function over time. So the critical thing is that we aim to support you in taking your career forward in the way that you want to over time. I think it's incredibly important that we look outside the profession, both inside government, so we work very closely with colleagues in digital data and technology, but also that we are always searching for the very, very, very best ways of doing things. So the Office for National Statistics has a partnership with the Alan Turing Institute around data science and artificial intelligence to make sure that we are learning from the very, very best people and being at the cutting edge. That our flagship coronavirus infection survey is a partnership with the universities of Oxford and Manchester, and the colleagues there bring an enormous amount to the, both the analysis and to improving the capability of our teams in the future. And finally, we work really, really closely with our colleagues in other national statistics institutes across the world to make sure that we are sharing best practice. So collaboration with analysts outside the profession in government, collaboration with analysts in academia, and collaboration with analysts internationally is a central part of what we do. Well, I've been privileged to be around sport for the whole of my life, and I'd like to continue to try to keep reasonably fit. I like to referee football matches. I have a son who is an extremely good footballer and cricket player, and I like to go and watch him, although it irks me sometimes that I have to pay money to watch him now.
Cheers, Ian. That's great. Right, let me stop the recording.